Hello everybody, welcome to another one day build. So I was planning to start working on a prototype for like a turn-based third person system today for the game I'm going to be making. I thought, why not make it a one day build? So that's what I'm going to do. And it's going to be based off this. I'm going to have some character swapping that I figured out a couple of months back for this project. So, yeah, I'm going to implement that character swapping between two characters. Let's just skip this cutscene. If I press tab now, you see that black orb over there? It'll swap between this first person character and that Black Ops flying character. And then press tab again, switches back. Press tab again, back to the orb. Press tab again, switches back. Back to the orb. So, that's what we're going to be doing. Just make sure my stream's up and running. Everything looks good. Feel free to post in chat or whatever.
Right.
So, first, I am going to grab a couple of blueprints. What I've done is I've just set up a new third-person template. Let's get things jiggered about on this. Start content, mannequin, third person. What we want to do is new folder. And it's going to be transition. Character transition. What? No, I don't want it in there. I want it in the content. Let's get this third person character. Hey, third person character. Yep, lovely. Play new editor window. Start working nicely. Actually, I don't like the camera on that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just edit this so that it's more to my liking. I want my camera to be closer, over to the right a bit. I wonder if you can see the view from that camera. No. Perspective 90 FOV sounds good. Right, let's just give that a bash. Whoa, that's way too close. Needs to go up and needs to come back. What height is my player? Probably put it up a bit more. Let's try that. Yeah, that feels good. Whee. Is that good? I'm not sure. It's looking forward. So that's looking quite good. Right. What I'm going to do is duplicate this blueprint, and I'm going to call it BP Catcher 1. Gonna whack it in that new character transition thing. Move here. Yeah. I'm gonna need a transition because it's turn based. You're gonna be switching between characters to do their turn and then switch back to other characters. Switch to an overhead map. We might be able to implement that today. No promises though. Let's duplicate that again. Yeah. There we go. Car 2. File, save all. Now, Let's just check out what I did on this one. Oh, I need, I need to go in here, project settings, set up some, inputs. Where are they? Should be around here. There we go, input. Action mapping. New action mapping. This is going to be switch character. Yes. And it's going to be tab. For now. Tab seems about right. Also, we'll put some on the control pad as well. Control pad, switch character. We're gonna have to switch quite regularly. Let's just put it on the shoulder button. Gamepad. Shoulder. I don't want motion control. Gamepad. Shoulder. Left shoulder. Why not? Left shoulder sounds about right. Yeah, that'll do. And then we want to do. Right, we'll keep all his movement and stuff up and running. Don't think we need any VR stuff going down. Gamepad input, yeah. Jump, touch input. Not having any of that bullshit. So let's get switch character. That's our input that we just set up. Now what do we want it to do? I think how I did it was, how did I do it? When the switch character is pressed, we want to possess a new transition character, which is basically a camera, and that camera will set its location to the position of the character we just had possessed, and then move to ease to the position of the character we want to possess, and then once it's there it'll possess a new character. Yeah. Sounds about right to me. Right, so let's just check my old project, make sure that's how I did it. Yeah. Did I not have switch characters a bit? Swaps first person, display menu, initialize, stick input. Oh, here we go. Import character switch. This is my old blueprint. Character active. Oh, I had a boolean for character active. Okay. If this character active is true, yeah, that sounds about right. Yep. Right, so character transition. What am I doing? In our new one, we want a new boolean. You know what? Let's create a function. Let's have this as a function, eh? Swap to next car. Char. And this boolean is car active. So if that is active, if we're active at this moment, actually we'll do this in the event graph, get that branch, and if we are active, we're going to do this function. Reference first person character. All right, okay. So, yes. Construction script. First of all, let's get rid of this guy. Put this guy in here. It's doing nothing. World settings. Game mode. Where's my game mode? Default pawn class. You know what? Let's set up a game mode, shall we? Dead person, BP character 1. Let's see what happens now. Let's just make sure that's the right character. That'll be BP character 2 there then. Character 1, we're going to have him, his mesh. Let's grab this material. Body color. Lovely. Okay, let's create a duplicate material. Material. Char 1. Body color. We'll have you as nice rusty orange. Okay, and then create a new material instance. Material 2. You know what, it should be IFA material instance. That's right. And you can be black. Maybe a purple black. Very, very deep. Purple. Yes, like it. Right, now, where are my characters? Character transition, character one. Rusty. Card one. Okay, that'll do. Compile, save. And at card two. That's the material. Just so we know what we're looking at when we transition. Oh, this stream's going to be at about 2 hours, probably. Compile, save. Right. Let's play. Right, so I am car one, there's car two. Very good. Doesn't he look cool? Yes. Right, here we go then. Construction. Car two. You know what, I want to have them in the level and have them just possessed at the gameplay. I don't want car one to spawn, I want it to already be in the level at the beginning of play. So, how do we do that? Third person game mode. If we get rid of that, might mess us up. Yeah, that's done. Forget about it. Just have it like that for now. Okay, so we need to get a reference a construction. Of class. Character two. Get the first one. And promote variable. Character 2, you're going to do it at begin play. Because this character's not going to be spawned. Begin play. Right. You know what, I'm gonna put a short delay in there. Wait for the character one to be spawned. 0.1 should be fine. And then I'm gonna get... of course. Car one. Get the first one. Should be the one that spawned at the beginning. And then promote to variable. Ref car one. Set that variable there. That should work fine. Comment. Set up ref to car one. Right, car one. Save all, please. Event, yeah. Swap to next character. What we want to do is we want another actor in our level, which is a character, and this one's going to be the transition car. BP. Which is basically, we don't need the mesh, although it is inherited, so let's just keep the mesh. We'll just, can we reduce the size? Not 0.01, and simulate physics, visible now, overlap, collision, none. Good. Where's the camera? I could not bring my passions from the common spring. Camera, you should be at 000. From the same source, I have not taken my source. Lovely, 90, the same FOV and stuff. Okay. Character movement, we don't need that either. Just check, it might be better off just creating a pawn instead of a character with all that extra bullshit in there. In my old one, I had a transition character. I can't come in. BP possession. What are you? You are. Pawn, yeah. Basically, just a camera. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Ha ha. Yeah, shots, shots. So let's get rid of that. And let's make a pawn. BP. Transition. Car. See, I did it right a couple of months ago. I'm just sticking in what I did a couple of months ago, basically. Save. But I want to do it again so I know what I'm kind of refreshed. I know what I'm doing when I'm working on this new game. This will actually do stuff. just a camera. At 90. Yep. Right now. So. Let's see what happens here. Swap to first person. So I'm sending a message to, I'm activating a custom event in the character I'm swapping to. Seems weird.
Jimmy,
I thought it would have been the other way around, where you send a message to the character transition. And then transition to the character you swap into, right? And then possess the character you swap into.
Until you're 21. Okay?
Cool. Yeah. Alright. Right, let's do this bit first. Copy. Let's just copy the whole thing. This is going in character 2 because we're swapping to character 2. So All right.
People can decide to become a Satanist, but it has to be in your heart naturally.
So we didn't even need any function there, did we really? All right then. So when my character one, let's get rid of this. We don't need that function. Event script. What? Goodness. Yes. We don't need that. What we need is reference to our second character. And then this. Custom event. Oh no, swap to car 2. Car 1, right, you get that and do swap to car 2. If you're active, what? There we go. Swap to car 2. When we do that, this shouldn't be car 1, this should be car 2, shouldn't it? I don't know why I had a function on an event. Don't ask. Want to do this. I want to get the car 1 reference. If the play pawn is currently PP car 1. Get car 1. Get the camera. Get the follow camera. Then what was I doing? Get the camera. Get the transform. Spawn at BP possession transition. Yes. Yes. That's right. Car 2. Maybe this guy. Oops. BP. Transition thing, transition character. Yeah, that'll do. Possess the transition character, which is now spawned at the same location and rotation as the character camera. Yes. Then what did we do? What's this? Camera transition data. Transition from 2 transition data transition to 0. Don't get that bit.
Whoa.
Ugh. swap character. Character component. Camera component. Right, let's have a go with that. Swap character. What is this? An interface with a function in it? Why? Alright. Transition data struct. Blimey hell. Is this the right way to do it? It worked before, didn't it? So it must be. Right. Was that a struct? What was that? That was an interface. Character transition interface. In my widgets interface, can swap interface. I'm confused right now. Why do I need an interface? Oh, I might be swapping to a third character for the top-down view and multiple other characters, so maybe in case it's a good idea, yes. Okay. Yeah. This is going pretty slowly. Right, you're going to get times like this in these one day builds when not much is happening because I'm trying to figure things out. Why is this in the model creation thing? Camera transition thing, why is that in there? I'll put that somewhere else. Right, okay, I'm gonna make gonna get this camera transition data set up first, which is a struct. What am I doing? Back over here. Right, let's make a struct. Blueprint class struct. It's not, is it? It's not random, isn't it? Struct. There we go. It was a blueprint. And we're going to have bytes. Let's just have name. Car one, there you go, car two. Is this even the right way to do it? I'm not with it today at all. I'm just getting back into the swing of things here. And this is not happening. Let's just chill out for a bit. It's like I've just totally lost the memory of everything I've learned over the last 3 years. Switch on name, switch on struts. How does that work? I used to be able to switch on name. Switch on name? Switch on name, is it? What the fuck am I doing? What am I doing at all? Character transition data, yeah? And what's in that character camera transition data? It's a struct. Strokes, them interfaces, here are my strokes, character transition, transition from integer, transition to integer, yes, but I'm going to use name instead of an integer. Yeah. Ugh. Right, this is transitioned from which character? Hey, go back. What? Ah! I don't need that pit. For God's sake, man. Is there something playing? No. There we go. And let's just fucking paste it. Push through maximum effort, search and destroy. Name. Yes. Okay. Save. Right. We've got that bit. This one. Swapped character 2. Swaps this character. What we want to do is we want to store that data somewhere. Level blueprint, maybe? I'll just create, I'll create a blue, no, 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 no. No. Let's just put it in the level, in a blueprint. And the blueprint is called... Transition Controller. Yes. If there's anyone who's recently tuned in, I'm basically trying to make a top-down style of character turn-basing. So we're doing the transition from one character to another, basically. And back up to an overhead map. Trying to get there. Not successfully at the moment. Yeah, we'll stick that in the map. And that's going to hold our struct. Which was called... I don't know. Transition struct. That'll do. It's going to be a struct. Okay, right, so this holds that struct data. Now we want to get that data. What we're going to do is character one. We're going to also do this again, but it's going to be the transition controller promote its variable transition controller. No, 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 no. Delete that. Get. Promotes variable. Yes. Transition controller. Okay. Lovely, lovely jubbly. Oh, thank God we don't have to do any more of that casting. I hated that in the first few builds of UE4. Event graph. And you need it as well. So, get all actors, of course. Transition controller. Get the first one. Promotes variable. Ref. Transition controller. Blah, 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 blah. That's the same transition controller. Right. Character 1. It ain't graph. What are you doing? Get reference to character 2. Swap character. Yes. Then. Swap character. Then. Get the reference transition controller. Get the structure thing. What was it? Data or something? Get transition data. Okay. And what did we do with it, Mr. Is it this one? Yeah. Oh, we set it. Transition from car 1, transition to car 2, then what? Swap character. Swap character. That'd only be going to where's this swap character going to? An interface, and it's going to anyone with that interface, which is can't find references. Oh, okay. I think all the work's being done in the character swappy thing. Yeah, here it is. Event swap character, get the data, and then yeah, that's where it's going. That's where the interface is going. That's where it's going. That's where it's going. But why don't I just make it a custom event? Why not? I don't understand. Why do I need that interface there? Multiple things can call one custom event. Why would I need it to be an interface? Pastdean, tell me. Speak to me, Pastdean. Right, what have you done here? Talk to your future self. Oh, I left myself messages. Sets character switch prompts. Sets variables. Do we want character switch prompts? I put you on silent, buddy. Do I not? Switch made. Why would I need that? Oh, okay. If the character switch is made, then right, yeah, that we don't need that. Current transition data. What would that be? Struct current. The same struct. Yes, right. Okay. Something just clicked. What we're going to do is we're going to set up a custom event in transition character custom event. And it's going to be start transition, and we need inputs, we need a transition data struct. Yes, we also need a camera. Do we need the camera? Why isn't that camera for? They've already moved. We've already moved. Model mesh. What's that mesh for? Don't get that. Targeted mesh. Targeted mesh component variable. Where is it? And why have I got so many components? This is getting messy again. I don't understand the targeted mesh bit. Maybe I should have set this up before I started the streaming. Because this must be one of a hell of a boring stream. Just watching me confused. Confused as all hell. Targeted mesh component. What the hell's going on here? Let's grab some references, see what's happening with that. We're setting it and then we're using it here. Set, right. Ref to lock on, see. What? Oh, that's for the lock on camera. We don't need a mesh component for what we're doing. We don't need that. Lock on C is lock on camera. Input camera. What do we need that for? Find reference. Set input camera. See, we don't need an input camera. We're not using it. I think I had three cameras in this. Yeah, I had three characters that I could switch between. I had the lock on camera, yada 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 yada. Yep, okay, right, so I just need the transition data. Oh, I know. Man! Frustrating though sometimes when your mind just goes totally blank. I mean, I made all this, believe it or not. I made this like a couple of months ago. And now I'm looking at it and I just don't know what the hell's going on. But obviously I'm able to do it because I did it in the first place. Right. Transition data. I think all we need is a transition data. Right, let's get this straight. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to move this camera to the other character. Simple. With an ease. But I need to know which character I'm moving to, which is why I'm using the transition data struct. Okay. I need a reference to the cameras, I mean the characters. Right, so what I'm doing is I'm setting the struct. I'm getting a reference to all the characters. And then depending on the transition from, if that's more than one, hood on, hood off. Set the hood on, set the hood off. Alright, let's forget about the hood for now. Let's just get it swapping cameras. Bloody hell, how difficult is this to do? Right, so that's all I need. Then I need to... What's this doing here? Set that. I'm gonna call it, this is my transition character, yep. This is gonna be character strut, data. Do you really think they find it entertaining? I find it baffling. Why would they want to see someone struggle? Suppose it is a bit laughable. Right. Character data. Then we need the... Now this is just being spawned, so it will need to get... I'll do it in the construction script though. I'll get reference to... class. What the hell am I doing? Just not with it today. Get all actors of class. Character one. Promote variable. That is ref character one. Maybe I could just pass these over from. Instead of getting all the doing all the actors of classing, I could just pass these over from the You know what? I'm gonna store these in here instead of doing that every time. Get all actors. This will just happen once when the level loads. Get and just promote it. And that is ref to, oh, character one. Get rid of that. Promotes variable ref car one. We will get there. Got 45 minutes yet. I'm suddenly switched on now, so don't know what was wrong with me before. My brain's just kicked into gear. And when we make the top down map view, that'll be a third character later, but we'll add that in later. Let's just get swapping between character 1 and 2 done first. Right, that's good. Now, what I want to do is, character one. You should have a reference to the transition controller. Yes. Character two, you should have a reference to transition controller. Yes. So, when we swap here, when we go to character two and say swap to this character, we're going to pass the reference over to transition controller. No, not transition controller, to transition character here. Transition controller, right, this, I need a new variable. It's going to be a blueprint transition controller reference. Call it. Come on, where are you? Oh, there. Transition controller. There we go. And then let's just promote that to variable. Whenever we need a reference to character one or two, we can get it straight from there. So we don't need any of that every time this is spawned, which could be quite often. Because we just use one that's already spawned in the level that holds all that info. What's this one called? Transition controller. Boop. Right. Now we've got that set up. Once we do this. Kartu, are you even activating this? Transition character. Where's my transition character? Right, you. I want you to branch off there. What was the event called? Start transition or something? Yeah, start transition. Transition controller is that thing. Good. Let's tidy up these cables. Get you. I'll have another one. Thank you. Looks better. I think that'll work. So I'm working on a blueprint, which basically I've got two characters in my level, and I want to spawn a camera and transition from different characters, like turn-based strategy type thing. So there'll be like 10 characters at the end, and you can just switch between one to the next, and also to an overhead map. Kind of like this that I made a couple of months ago. Might as well show you. Don't save that. So this is my first person character running around the place, and then I have a character which locks onto a mesh, so when I click on this there'll be a camera that spawned, and it'll take the transition to the next character, which is a mesh lock on character. and then you can go back to the other character nice and smoothly. I also have this character over here, which is like a little flying orb thing. Now I can either click on him and it'll transition, or I can run over here and press tab and it'll transition back to this orb. So I'm basically doing that. In essence, hopefully. But it's for a project that I'm working on, well, planning to start, which is third person turn based project. Right, character swap. Let's go back to Adrian, make sure I've done everything right. Right, yeah. Then, swap character, yeah. Character transition, don't need that. This is where we're up to. Done that bit. Got the references. Then. Don't need to set my HUD. Set camera variables. Now we're talking. Transition camera. Get the word transform of the camera. Then. Switch on in. Current transition data 2. If this is. Right, okay. I think I know now. Right, so I've done that. Yeah. On the transition character. Right, so I need a new variable, which is a transform. And this is transform A. Let's call it A, whatever. That's what it is in the other project, so we'll stick to that. I want to set that from my camera world transform. Get world transform. Set that. Then I want to get my character data, split the struct, switch on name. Add pin, case 0, case 1, and what? What would be my case 1 and case 0? No, I want to type in the name I want to switch from. You know what? Let's forget about names. Let's go back to this and we'll switch it to a byte. Actually, integer is probably best. Save. Switch on int. And we'll use. If it's 0, that's character 1. If it's 1, that's character 2. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to get the transform. If it's 0, transform of, I've got a reference to character 1 in here. Don't get that. We don't need that, do we? Or do we? No, we don't. What we want to do is we want to get this. If it's 0, that means that we're switching to character 1. I mean, we're switching to character 2, so we need to get character. Should be down at the bottom here. Variables. Character 2. Might as well get character 1 as well while we're at it. Get character 1. And we want to get the camera. Pop, 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 pop. Down, 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 down. Get follow camera. Get follow camera. Then transform. Get world transform. Same for you. Character 2, that's one, the one we're switching to, so we want to ease over to that, don't we? Oh, we're setting a transform B, right, okay, yeah, set transform B, so let's just duplicate that and call it B. Set transform B. If that's 0. If it's 1, we'll set transform B to be character 1 because we're switching back to character 1. Yeah? I'm talking to myself half time when I'm asking questions, so take no notice of that. Right, we're getting somewhere. I don't know where, but we're getting somewhere. That'll do. Right, so we've got our transform we're starting at, we've got our transform we want to get to, now we need to ease between the two. Let's see how I did it last time. Yeah, then camera movement. Oh, I've got a little timeline set up. I'm lurping between the two locations and rotations. Lovely. Via the driven by the timeline. Set location. Yeah, let's do that first. I don't know what this is all about. Why am I setting that again though? I'll just set it up here. I'm setting it every tick. I already know. Why am I setting it twice? There must have been a reason why I set it there before we started transitioning, started the movement of the camera, and then setting it every tick that the camera is moving here. It's the same thing. Location moved. Oh right, okay. That's just sending a message to the lock on camera. And then setting the HUD opacity, right, okay, that's for the HUD. We don't need to bother with that. We do not need to bother with that today. So let's set up that timeline. This one. Here we go. Once I've done that, sequence. Come on now. Sequence. There we go. If you over a bit. Timeline. And this is going to be transition movement. What time are we on? I've got about 20 minutes left before I have to go pick up my little boy from school. Right, so. Transition is going to be one second. I want it pretty quick. And we're going to go from 0 to 1. At 1 second, we're going to be at 1, and we're going to make it a nice little gentle curve so it eases in and out. Event graph. What's this all about? Track 0. I should have named that. Right, so we need to. World location, set world location and rotation of our actor, right? Self. Or just the camera? Yeah. Let's set the world transform. We're going to lerp between. Transforms. Lerp transform. We want to go from A to B during this time frame. Each tick will lurp a little bit along the line. Sweep, teleport. We don't want sweep on. No, we don't want that on. Do that. And then when we get to the other position, we want to possess our new character. Right. Now I'm confused again. I'm really having a bad day today at this. Right, we don't need to do any of that because that's for the HUD. Yes, possess a new character. We've done that. We've done transition camera. Yeah. We did that. Possess new character, then destroy this transition actor. Is this character even possessed? I guess it would be. Possess new character, but which character? Why would we need to set the rotation? Oh, maybe that's probably wise. Yeah, that's probably wise. So basically, we're nearly done here, guys. I'm just gonna copy this. Once we've finished here, I'm gonna get this character data, get this, split pin, position 2, get the controller, possess. Go. Now we just need to move that one down a bit. Delete that bottom one. Delete that one. We're getting there. Oh. There we go. Right, so if the character we're transitioning to is character 1, we need to possess character 1. Get reference to character 1. If the guy we're transitioning to is 1, we need to possess character 2. Get character 2. And we want to reset the camera of character 1. You know what, we're just going to copy that over there. Yep. camera, set follow camera, get follow camera for character 1 there, character 2 camera. Now, this is all going to go wrong. I'm going to press play now. Nothing happens. Nothing happens at all.
Hello, by all feast. Fast. 12.
Right, so why is nothing happening? Let's see what's triggering, what isn't triggering. Character 1. Input switch. Swap to character 2. Print string. Trigger. 1. I'm going to swap to character 2. We want to do this. Possess that. And then. Possess. The transition character. And do this. Show V. Trigger 2. Then I want to start the transition, which is do that and then do this. Trigger 3. And then once that's finished, we want to possess those guys. And trigger 4, trigger 5. Let's see if anything happens this time, eh? Let's see which triggers fire and which ones don't. Nothing's firing. It's almost as if my link isn't. My input isn't working. Let's try the controller input. I think it was left bumper. Controller's working, but input's not firing. Character 1, why aren't you firing? Input characters. Input action, switch character, right? Now let's try. Right. Get in there. It's switched, but it hasn't possessed character 2. Huh. Let's see which trigger's fired. Trigger 3, Trigger 4. Ooh. It did possess him. Did it possess? Which one was Trigger 4? Transition. Trigger 4. Possess. Alright, character data. Transition 2. Yeah. What do you think, guys? Why is it not possessing? Here's the thing. Here's the possession thing. Right, so it's going there. Character data transition 2. We're transitioning to 1, which is that one. Possess. Character 2. Right. Let's go to character 2. Let's go to the event graph. Let's go to unpossessed. Possessed, possessed, possessed. There we go. Event possessed. Let's go. Print string. Possessed too. Let's see if he's possessing. Alright, so. No, he's not possessing, is he? He's not being possessed. You see what's happening though? We're having like for a third person turn based strategy where you can switch to other players and then they can do their little go and then. Other person goes, then next person goes, then next person goes, and then end turn. Why is it not possessing? It's obviously that reference is true because we're getting the camera location from it and it's going to that camera location. Okay, so target in pawn. The pawn to be possessed is character 2, right? Or is it the other way around? Did I do it backwards? There we go. I think I had it backwards. There we go. Lovely. Now, is there a way to get it back? I think once we're possessed, we need to reset this. This thing. Oh yeah, we can destroy this actor now. Yeah, I'm possessed. Character 2. We would like to get the... Is this the transition thing? Transition controller. What's that all about? Are we using that anywhere? I've got 5 minutes left before I have to go. Yeah, that's not being used. So, want to get this transition controller, which is storing all our data for the swapping. Event possessed. We want to get that. We want to set the struct. Should be a struct here somewhere. Somewhere. Struct. Where are you? Transition controller there. Right, so character transition data, that's what I want to set. Set that to or do we? I think we do that at the beginning here, don't we? If Right, first of all, let's save all before we mess it up again. Yeah, we'll do it there. Set from to. Transitioning from 1, 2, 2. Oh. 1. Start transition. And then transition to 0, 1. Let's see what happens now. Whoa! I think I did have it right in the first place, didn't I, over here? What is going on there? Oh yeah, I've just broke everything. Anyway, I've got to go pick my little boy up from school, so I'll see everybody later. Thanks for tuning in. Tatty boys!